Hello and welcome back to the 3D Printing Club's YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about MiniProject 3 for the Mizzou class ISLT 4310/73. Today in particular, this MiniProject is going to be about how to make a nut and bolt in Fusion 360. Let's go ahead and get started. First thing you need to do is you need to create a sketch. Select any plane you want and start sketching. The first thing you're going to do is go to circle, center diameter circle, select the origin, and for this mini project, we're going to go ahead and type in dimensions while it is being created. Click once on the origin of your circle, and then you should be able to type in the amount that you want. For this first circle, we want it to be 10 millimeters in diameter. So if you were zoomed out a little bit, go ahead and zoom in to make it take up more of your screen. Next, we're going to create a polygon to fit around this circle. In particular, it'll be a bit bigger, you know, we're making the head of the bolt. So sketch, go down to polygon, circumscribed polygon. It means that all of the sides will be tangent to some point on the circle. Go ahead that. So we would like this radius to be 10 millimeters. Notice that this one is radius, not diameter. And we do want six sides. So go ahead and hit enter. And now we have our polygon, our hexagon, on top of our circle. Now we're going to stop the sketch. We're going to add mass to our bolt, or rather the head of the bolt. We're going to need to select the surface of the polygon and the inner circle. For the distance, we're going to also make this 10 millimeters. Okay, now our sketch has been hidden. We need to make sure we can see it. Rotate to the bottom of our part. Go to create, extrude again. This time, however, we're going to be selecting the circle, and we need to make sure that we're going down our negative number of 50 millimeters. This is to create the cylinder that our bolt will have. You can now hide the sketch. Now we're going to be adding the threads to our bolt. This is incredibly simple and straightforward. You go to create, thread, select the cylinder or circular face that you wish to be threaded. Now it's important that you go ahead and make sure that this check mark is checked, the modeled part. Since we do actually want our 3D printer to make these threads, we need to make sure that we have it modeled. Go ahead and click remember. This is important so that way the next time we use the thread feature, like for our nut, it will remember exactly the same type of thread that we use. For this in particular, we're going to be using an ISO metric profile. The thread size will be 10 millimeters because that is the size of our shaft that we created. In the designation, you should always try to pick the item that has the larger second number. The M10 times 1.5. That determines how big the thread actually is in comparison to the length. So for an example, I'll show you what a M10.5 looks like. You can now see that the threads are much smaller and there are a lot more of them. This is an issue when it comes to 3D printing because these tolerances have to be a lot tighter for the 3D printer to print it correctly. While if we use a designation more like M10 times 1.5, we get smaller number of threads, but they're bigger and therefore have a little bit more play in them when we do need to actually 3D print them. Class should auto-populate based off of the thread type and size. Direction you'll want to keep right-handed because it means you'll go clockwise to tighten, counterclockwise to loosen. Righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. Once we confirm that all of our aspects are correct, go ahead and click OK. And there is our bolt. Nice and almost finished. If you'll notice right here that we have kind of this offset circle from our thread. It's not perfectly a center diameter. It is offset. Most bolts actually have a small taper or fillet on the edge of this bolt. In order to make sure that that is created properly, there is a method that you need to use. This method involves first suppressing the thread, adding your fillet, and then unsuppressing your thread. Down in the history tab, you need to right click on your thread feature, and you need to suppress feature. Click click that. Now your thread disappears, but you notice that it's still there in the history bar. Next, you need to go to Modify, Chamfer, select this outer edge circle, and pick a number. For this, let's go ahead and do 2.5 millimeters. Now you need to right click on your suppressed thread feature and unsuppress the feature. You'll notice that the fillet has now automatically been tuned into the thread. Now that we have our bolt created, we need to go ahead and create our nut. The way that we can do that is by hitting sketch, but this time clicking on the top circle that was created by our fillet on our bolt. Go ahead and create two objects. Again, one a circle with a center diameter of 10 millimeters. And the next object needs to be, again, a polygon circumscribed, starting at the origin. The radius needs to be 10 millimeters. And it needs to have six sides. It's important to make sure that your nut lines up with your bolt right now. This will mean that when it screws all the way together, it will be perfectly in line with your bolt. You can do that by selecting the tip of your new polygon and the tip of your old polygon, now the bolt, and going over to your sketch palette and hitting coincident. Now we can go ahead and stop the sketch. Go to Create, Extrude, select just the outer profile, do not select the circle, and for the distance, again, make it 10 millimeters. Make sure that you're going away from the bolt so we don't accidentally combine the bolt and the nut right now. The next step after this is to again add the thread. Create, thread, select your circular shape, which will be the inner circle of the nut. Because we clicked remembered, it will have automatically selected the correct settings for our profile to make sure that the thread of our nut will fit with our bolt. Hit OK. Next, what you need to do is again do the chamfer trick. So right click on the new threaded feature, suppress it, modify, chamfer, select this edge of the circle and the bottom edge, so that way we don't have a top and bottom to our nut. This time we're only going to do 1 millimeter for the chamfer. Hit OK. Unsuppress your second thread feature. Now there's one problem with this. If we were to print this model right now, the threads would be exactly the same size. When something has that tight of tolerance, there's too much friction and it ends up seizing up or being unable to turn. So the thing we need to do now is to upscale our thread. In order to do this, we're going to need to use the Modify Scale tool. However, we want the outer perimeter of our nut to stay the same size. First, you will need to hide the bolt body. Make sure we aren't accidentally selecting anything from there. Make sure you can view either the top or the bottom of your nut. Go to Sketch, click one of the faces, either the bottom or the top, to create a sketch. Now you need to create a circle starting at the origin, center diameter, and it needs to expand past your threads, but not quite to your polygon shape, kind of like that. Now you can stop sketch. Next, we need to go to Modify, Split Body. Body to split, we need to make sure we're selecting our nut. Splitting tool is going to be that circle that we just created. Go ahead and select that. You'll notice that a red preview will come up. The extend splitting tool can be on or off. Basically, this just increases the split of the body, but since we have such a small part, it's not really needed. Go ahead and click OK. You'll notice in our body tab, we now have two bodies where we had one. Body 2 is now body 2 and body 3. In order to scale this one part, you need to select it, modify, scale. The correct scale factor for the ISLABS printers and for most printers in general with this size of thread is 1.1, or 10% bigger. You'll notice that it automatically selects a point based on the body. This isn't good because it ends up off-centering our threads and making our bolt not line up perfectly with our nut. So go ahead and hit the X button on the select feature and make sure you can view the origin in the browser. This is simply done by making the blue light bulb into a yellow light bulb and select the origin point as the center point. Make sure it's on uniform and at a scale factor of 1 to 1. If you change it to a non-uniform scaling, it will mess up your threads and they will not fit together like they should. Once you scale, if you do select the origin, you'll notice that they won't be aligned correctly anymore. This is an easy fix. What you'll need to do is take your body 3, modify, move, take one of your arrows, and just slide it in manually until you can see it fitting. It's okay if there's a little bit of overlap on each side. In fact, that's what you're kind of going for. So in this case, the displacement that we need to do is negative 5.5 millimeters, and that'll ensure that there's a tab on either side of the nut. Now what you need to do is combine both of these bodies, body 2 and body 3. Again, this will be under the modify tool, combine. Select both of the bodies you want, target body, tool body, operation needs to be joined. Now those two bodies have been combined into one. As you can confirm in your browser menu, you can go ahead and turn off the origin for now. You will no longer need it. Now we're done with our nut. Well, almost. Well, we left the two tabs on either side. We don't want that. Fusion 360 allows you to do a really easy, convenient thing. Select the face of the feature that's extending too far and just hit delete. It'll automatically remove it for you in the proper manner. Same thing for the other side. Select the face of the cylinder, hit delete. And that is how you create a nut and a bolt. Now that we have both the nut and the bolt file created in Fusion 360, this is the time to go ahead and save the model and export each body as its individual STL file. You can do that by File, Save for the Fusion 360 file, and by going to Make 3D Print and selecting each body one at a time to save as a STL file. Remember to make sure Send 3D Print Utility is checked off so it doesn't try to open up any other programs for you. This thread style and scaling factor have been confirmed to work on the ISLAB printers. If you're working on a printer somewhere else, these tolerances may need to be changed slightly to get a better fit for your printer and your printer's accuracy. Remember to leave a comment down below for additional mini projects unrelated to the ISLT 4310 7310 class.
Hi, thank you for watching our video, and feel free to comment or subscribe or like this video and watch any of our other videos in our series.